Hey, welcome to Rygaard Creations. In this video, I'm going to show you how to save and make backups of the interface layout or workspace in 3DCoat, okay? Great. First of all, it's very important that we know how to save and backup the interface, okay? It's a very simple process to do, and at some point, for sure, the simple save process, which is often ignored by people, will literally save your life. That's right. I can tell all of you that problems really happen here inside 3DCoat. And believe me, many times I was only able to recover what I had done in the interface because I had a backup, okay? For this, I go to the Windows menu. And here we have two options to save the interface layout. The first option is right here, Store Displayed Layout. This command will only save this interface layout that we are currently in an external file with .onePageLayout extension. This means that if we make changes elsewhere within 3DCoat, all these changes will not be saved and will not be part of this external saved configuration file, okay? Great. The second option is Store Workspace. Store Workspace will save all the panels and modifications that we make in all places of the interface inside 3DCoat. In a single external file with a .3DCpack extension. Surely you may be wondering, what would be the best option? So, I am going to be very honest with you. Currently, I always use it, and I would like to suggest you do the same as I do. Always choose the Store Workspace option. This is the best option to save everything we come to modify in the interface, okay? Great. I'm going to stop recording and I'm going to make some changes to the interface to make it look a little different. Don't worry about it now. We'll see in later videos, okay? That's it. So, to save all the changes made to the 3DCoat interface, I'm going to go to Windows menu and choose the Store Workspace option. And then, I'm going to choose a place here on my computer to save the file, okay? In this case, inside this folder, I'm going to save it with a name Rygaard Test. And as you can see, this file will have the extension .3DCpack. So, I'm going to click on the Save button to save it. Great! Now, I'd like to show you how to do another type of backup. This time, you have to open the Documents folder. Inside the Documents folder, you'll find the 3DCoat 2021 folder, which was created when we installed 3DCoat, okay? Here, inside the 3DCoat 2021 folder, you enter the user preference folder and then the rooms folder. Inside this rooms folder, we'll find this custom rooms folder. I will go into the custom rooms folder just to show you a few things. As you can see here inside, we'll have all these folders related to 3DCoat's rooms. And inside each one of them, we'll find specific interface configuration files that we use a lot in the future, okay? But let's go back to the rooms folder. I will select the custom rooms folder. Press Ctrl C on my keyboard to copy it. And then I will choose a folder anywhere on my computer. For that, I'm going to pause the video. And now, inside the backup folder that I created, I will simply press Ctrl V on the keyboard to paste. Now, we have a backup of all the files that are part of the rooms in 3DCoat. Great! So, from now on, I always do two simple things. First, for all the changes made to the 3DCoat interface, use the store workspace command to save. And second, just copy the custom rooms folder to another place on the computer to make a backup, okay? Now, I'm going to show you how to recover an interface through the external file that was saved earlier, okay? Don't worry about what I'm going to do now. Here on the interface, everything will be shown in other videos later on. I will make any changes here in the interface to make it look very different. Or we might think that this could be the result of some problem that happened in 3DCoat. That's it. So, to recover the interface that I had before, I go to the Windows menu. And at this point, I have to choose one of the two options that are found here. If I saved the interface using Store Display Layout option, then I'll have to choose the command Restore Display Layout. But if I saved the interface using the Store Workspace command, then I'll have to choose the Restore Workspace command, okay? In my case, I saved the interface using the Store Workspace option. So, I'll have to choose the option Restore Workspace, okay? I will click on the Restore Workspace command. In this window, I go into the location that I saved the file on the computer with. In this case, it's just inside the Rygaard Creations folder. And then, I'm going to select the Rygaard test.3dcpack file. And I'm going to click the Open button. As you can see, I successfully recovered the interface I had before, right? Right. Now, regarding the custom rooms folder, which we made a backup copy of, it's necessary to be very careful when using it to recover something. My suggestion to you is not to use this folder until you learn all the things I'm going to show you in later videos, okay? But in case you need it, for some reason, what you need to do is the following. Go to the location where you have the backup copy of the custom rooms folder on your computer. In this case, I'm already inside this folder. Select the custom rooms folder and press Ctrl C on the keyboard to copy it. Next, go to the documents folder. Enter the 3DCoat 2021 folder, the user preference folder, and then the rooms folder. Inside this rooms folder, just press Ctrl V on the keyboard to paste. Of course, I won't do that right now, okay? But in the Windows file transfer window, just click the button to confirm the replacement of the original custom rooms folder with the backup folder, okay? So, don't do this process until you know exactly what you are doing. Otherwise, you might lose important files, okay? Great. Don't miss the next video. I'm going to start the first video of a long series of tips, secrets, and many interesting things inside 3DCoat, okay? I hope you have learned something new, and as always, I will see you all in the next video. See you there.